to DC and I'm walking to Kitsuyan restaurant. That is Pusha T's new ramen noodle bar. And parking's pretty tight. Although in general, parking's pretty tight in DC. It looked like they got valet driving, but you know, I'm not gonna pay for that. So I found a parking spot like 3 minute walk from there. So it looked like it's gonna be a little noisy in there because this is like the opening weekend and all that. So I'm gonna just like show y'all everything that's going on, but you're not really gonna see me talking. And if you do, well, that's all just luck. So yeah, just, you know, stick around with me and we gonna see how this restaurant's food tastes. For making sure I got back home safe too. So sweet of y'all. But my review of Kitsuyan Ramen Bar, I actually surprisingly enjoyed it. I was really worried when I decided to go. Well, I was excited that I found something to do a video on, you know, another video on, but now that it was time to go, I'm just like, am I even gonna be able to record? Like, you know, he's like a famous rapper that owns the restaurant. Like, I felt like, for those of y'all who are in New York City, I felt like what I was gonna walk into was gonna be like Woodland restaurant in Brooklyn, where, you know, you walk in and girls are twerking on top of the bar and people are at their, you know, dinner tables twerking and all that stuff. Like, that's totally what I thought it was gonna be like, but it was really chill. Like, I felt so relaxed. After I finished eating, I was still sitting there just chilling. Like, although I was tired as hell because, listen, on Sundays, I do an 11-hour shift. And the night before, I had to babysit, so I was only sleeping for like 4 hours, so I'm like exhausted. But I'm like, you know, I missed opening day because I had other things to do, and I have 11-hour shift I do on Sunday, so I don't want to wait till tomorrow because I got to shoot for, you know, the MLK parade. So I'm like, F it, like, we just gonna, you know, make it through to the night. And it'll be great to eat and be able to sleep good, you know? But it was really chill. Like, I kind of thought I was gonna walk into what I thought the restaurant would be, because as soon as I walked in, they asked for my ID, and I'm just like, ID? Like, is this a ramen bar or is this a club? Like, I'm confused. Like, but it was like, oh, that after a certain time, they open up the hookah section. But yeah, so everybody has to be ID'd. I'm just like, oh,
Okay, I didn't even know they was gonna have hookah. So that's an interesting combo. You got your ramen, you got your hookah. But it's very neat in there. They do have tables you can reserve, but I went solo, so I just sat at the bar. But it wasn't hard to get the bartender's attention, which is a big problem, you know? I'm sure everybody can agree whenever you go to clubs, it's a huge problem trying to get the bartender's attention. But the place is really small, honestly, which I guess that's why it's so relaxing and chill, because it's small, you know? So it's very intimate. So, yeah, but the staff are extremely friendly. I don't know if because it's opening day and all the management is there, that's why, but I don't know. I kind of felt like it was sincere that they were very friendly. I really felt it. Because they consistently, all of them kept asking like if we were okay, if there's anything else we wanted. Like, I don't know. I felt like they hired really good people. And they're actually still hiring too. So if anybody lives in the DC area, you could go work at a restaurant that just opened up. So, the food. So whenever I go do these food logs, I just be asking, listen, what is your most popular meal? What is your most popular drink? And as y'all saw earlier in my video, that's what I ate. I said in the video too that that drink did not even taste like alcohol. It tasted like soda. But I mean, I had to drive back to Baltimore anyway, so it's good that I didn't have liquor. There was another drink too that I heard a lot of people requesting. So I'm surprised the bartender didn't say that that was, you know, another popular drink. But I don't know, I guess because the name sounds kind of funny, that's why people were ordering it. I should have probably asked one of the people who drank it like how it was. But if a lot of people ordering it, then it must be good. And of course at bars, you know, they can mix whatever kind of drinks you want, you know. So the food, so again, I had an 11-hour shift. I was starving, and I'm a foodie anyway, so you know I was hungry. So, and I'm about to go to sleep, so you know that meal was good for me and whatnot. But the guy next to me, he was like asking me like, you know, specific questions about like how I like the meal. So I'm like, you know, it's good, you know. It has your veggies in it, and then it's not actually spicy. And then you got your noodles, and then it have pork in it. He was like, well, what would make it better? I'm just like, well, I would like to have some cut up sausage, like you know, the breakfast sausage you have, the not the patty sausage, but you know, the one that kind of looks like a thumb, those kind of breakfast sausages, like chop them up and put them in that ramen, and then make the soup much more spicier. That I think would have made it much better. That I would say. But I mean, it was good, and their prices are very good. Like, if y'all saw my other video, like doing the review of Beyonce's new line, like her shit is overpriced for how it looks, honestly. And you would think, okay, there's another celebrity doing something, and it's probably gonna be high ass priced, you know, menu and stuff. But no, that shit is good. Like for my drink and then my food, I only paid $40. Like, where they do that at? His prices are good, and it's like it was a big bowl. Like, I'm gonna sleep good once I'm done with this video. Like, I really like the restaurant, honestly. Like, I really only did this cover because I felt like, you know, it would be relevant to you guys who listen to Pusha T's music, but I really like that restaurant. Like, I was really just sitting there and chilling, like after I finished eating, and everybody who was there was friendly, not only staff, but people who were, you know, there already. And it was just really chill, really intimate and small, neat. And I was surprised that it was H&M music playing. I don't know, maybe that's what kept the mood kind of calm and whatnot. Because, you know, when, like, your surroundings are a certain way, it's going to make you a certain way. So it's a calm atmosphere. So I guess everybody felt calm and whatnot. But yeah, it was H&M music playing. No rap, no R&B, no twerk, no nothing. Like, God was on my side tonight because I didn't know what I was going to walk into. Yeah. I actually like it. I want to really go back. I mean, I don't mind doing food vlogs with people. As y'all see, when I went to Jimmy's, I brought my friend. And I was actually hoping, like, my friends who live in D.C. or near D.C. would have went to this with me. And, you know, I mentioned it to them even when I was supposed to go the original New Year's Eve date that it was supposed to open. But nobody wanted to roll. So, I mean, I guess hopefully after y'all see this video, y'all would actually want to go there because I legit just like the atmosphere. The food is okay, you know, but the atmosphere is just real nice. If you just want to be able to go out with, like, your friends or on a date to just somewhere that's really chill and intimate, like, that's the perfect place to go to. Like, honestly, it's so relaxing. Probably definitely, all right, that restaurant, the best occasion to go to that restaurant for, I would say, is for a date. Like, really chill, relaxing, you know. I would say for a date. Forget about with your friends, because you probably want to act up and get snatched up with your friends. But for a date, I would definitely say that, honestly. Unless you want to do the hookah, of course, because upstairs, literally, it was huge-ass groups, like, doing the hookah. It wasn't, like, you know, one, two, three people, like. They actually say that Saturday, the first open day, was packed. So I guess it is good that I didn't go Saturday because, well, it would have probably been too crazy for me to record. It was much more calm today. But yeah, I really like it. I want to go back again, honestly. It's just the atmosphere that makes me want to be there. I've never went to go eat somewhere and like an atmosphere that much, honestly. Like, I just be wanting to get my food and go home, you know. Unless the place has Wi-Fi, that's what would make me want to stay in a restaurant. But yeah, I really just like the atmosphere. I don't know, maybe it's just me. I wish I could ask, like, how other people felt about it, because the atmosphere is what makes me like the place, definitely. Oh, and Pusha was actually there. It's weird because, like, I'm just recording, vlogging, and, like, after I, like, you know, rotated the phone, I'm just like, did I just see? And mind you, I don't really know him like that. Like, I first started hearing his name back when I was in college, right? People would always say his name, and I don't know. I learned about so much different music when I was in college. Like, honestly, I'm an R&B girl, but in college, I learned about my dancehall music, my hip-hop. Like, that's really when I started getting into all them other genres, because literally before that, all I listened to was R&B and pop. So I would hear his name a lot, you know, from friends or people who was in my circle. And I just knew the name, and I didn't really actually know his face until one day they talked about him on the Wendy Williams show. And that was a couple of years ago when his last album came out. Well, I don't know if he had an album since then, but that was the only time I seen his face, you know, because I watch Wendy religiously. So that's why I'm just like, did I just see him? I had to go back downstairs and, like, go to Google and ask the guy that I was sitting next to that, did you see a guy that looks like this upstairs? He's like, oh, yeah, he's upstairs. I'm just like, oh, okay. I thought I was bugging because the way he was just sitting there, like, you wouldn't even be able to tell it was him, honestly. Like, he was just sitting like on a couch by himself. Mind you, I told you when I went upstairs to the hookah, it was huge groups. It was actually just two huge groups on opposite sides of the room upstairs. And then just one couch had just him, which I didn't really, think much of it. But yeah, after I thought about it for a second, I'm like, hold up. Did I just see? And I'm even surprised he's actually like there. Like, I would have thought like yesterday, at least he'll be there or just not be there at all. Because most of these other, celebs, when they do some kind of project, they don't actually show up. They just have their staff be there. But yeah, he was definitely there tonight. I don't know if he was there yesterday. I don't know if he's gonna be there tomorrow, but it's pretty cool, how he actually did his project and he was just there. Like, the way he was sitting there, like, how can I describe it? Y'all know when, like, okay, let me see. For those of my people who have experience working in retail, right? Y'all know when, like, somebody's in training, right? Right? And it's another associate training a new person, right? And the manager of the, let's say, Forever 21, for example, is just walking around, right? They're not talking to nobody. They're just walking around, just observing what everybody's doing, but they don't say nothing. They don't go up to nobody, nothing. They just walk around observing, and they probably just go right back into the office and do whatever it is they was doing. That's pretty much how it was tonight with him, He was just observing, which was pretty cool, But yeah, I really enjoyed the restaurant, honestly. I've been wanting to like just go to DC for the longest to just eat. Because they have a lot of unique like restaurants and stuff. So this is kind of like my first one. So hopefully many more to come. I definitely want to go back there, and I'm dragging friends this time because they was trying to play me like, oh, they're not really interested. Well, as you see, I really enjoyed being there. So I'm going back with other people because it's just really nice and relaxing, Life is just so stressful, and it's like sometimes you just want to like go somewhere where you could just like, you have your mind cleared. Not that my mind got cleared over there, but I wasn't really thinking about like literally anywhere I go, I'd just be thinking about, bills or things I gotta do. But over there, I literally was just, my mind was clear. Like, it was about that place. When I walk in H&M, do I have the same feeling? I don't think so. Because that's the kind of music they was playing, H&M music. I don't know. My mind was just so clear over there. I don't know what they sprayed in the air, but y'all need to go there. It's just a nice place to go relax, honestly. Like, it's like a spa, but without getting a rub down. That's literally how it is over there. But yeah, that's my review. And they had a lot of nice paintings as well on there. Even like they had a Japanese style bathroom door, like you gotta slide in and all that. Well, I don't know if it's Japanese. Don't kill me, my fellow Asians. But yeah, it's pretty nice. Even though, I was kind of worried, and like the street it's on, I'm familiar with the street, so I'm just like, ooh, but I really enjoyed my time there. I recommend all of you guys to go there. So yeah, hopefully y'all keep keeping up with me because I'm back on it again tomorrow to do another cover for the MLK Day Parade in Baltimore. Your girl is tired, I be disappearing, and then anytime I come back, I be giving y'all like three videos in a week. So it's like, I'm getting the hang of YouTube, guys, okay? I'm new to YouTube, so y'all just gotta keep hanging with me, okay? I'm gonna get better, okay? I'm not gonna give up. I'm learning, and I'm gonna keep on trying to give y'all things that are interesting, things that are interesting to me and things that I think will be interesting to you guys. So yeah, I'll be seeing y'all tomorrow. I'm gonna be all bundled up and we're gonna see how this goes, you know. But as always, thank you for keeping up with me. Make sure you subscribe, you like, you comment. Like, I love the interaction, I really do. And I do subscribe back too, you know. I like to support people that support me, you know. But yeah, I'll see y'all later. I'm about to go to bed. Good night.